Welcome to another segment of 30 Minutes with Jesus. Today is 18th of December. That reminds me of my little sister's birthday. If she was alive today would have been her birthday. So I just pray that her soul will continue to rest in peace in Jesus' name. Amen. So we are going to get right into it. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this opportunity to be yet again in your presence. We surrender to your perfect will. We ask that the Holy Spirit will inhabit this place and speak through me as his oracle, that the people might be blessed when hearing this word of God at any time, at any year, at any season, that they will continuously be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. So folks, I hope you had a lovely week. Well, I wouldn't say I did. Well, I did, because I was writing exams. So it's been really tough this season for me. So anyway, today's topic is actually what the Holy Spirit put in my heart. Grace. That's today's topic, grace. Grace is an unmerited divine assistance given to humans for their regeneration or sanctification, or a virtue coming from God, or a state of sanctification enjoyed through divine assistance. That's the layman's definition regarding grace. Let's look at what the Bible dictionary says about grace. Grace is freely given, unmerited favor and love of God towards man. It is also a virtue or excellence of divine origin. That is what the Bible dictionary tells us about grace. And then it was first mentioned in Genesis chapter 6 verse 8, but it was used as favor. And then if you could remember this verse that says Noah finds favor in the eyes of the Lord, this is just to, you know, to tell you where it was mentioned and how it was used. So this is the Bible dictionary explanation of grace. You are all aware that the word grace has appeared in the Bible for 170 times, to be precise. And although there are five graces of God, what we are going to look at today is grace in the person of Jesus Christ. As you all know, this is Christmas season. Well, I like to say that though Jesus was not born this season, but as Christians, our forefathers in the faith have come in agreement to choose this day to celebrate his birth. Doesn't mean that it's biblical, but this is a day that was chosen. Christians all around the world to grace the Messiah, anyway, or celebrate the Messiah, the birth of the Messiah. Anyway, so it is interesting that the Bible tells us that grace is a person, and that person is Jesus Christ. Why do you think Jesus is grace himself? Because of what the Bible tells us in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5. So if you have your Bible, you can open it with me in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. 2 Corinthians chapter 5. I know, if you're there, then you're faster than me. Okay, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21. It says, "For he had made him to be sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him." What is this telling you and I? Jesus himself was made sin. He was made sin. That is why, if you remember, the biblical meaning of grace, this is biblical. The grace is freely given, unmerited favor and love from God. So you see, if this tells, if 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21 tells us that Jesus was made sin, that is to say that we switched places with Jesus, because he knew no sin. We are the guilty ones here. But Jesus took our place and became sin itself in order for us to be reconciled to the Father. If you remember what grace means, that is, grace is freely given, like I said. God gave his son freely. We did nothing for God to give, to freely give us his son. Let us read John 3:16. You all know the verse. It's a popular verse that even evangelists use. John 3:16. Another evangelist uses this script to this script, particular scripture, to minister to the lost souls. So you, it's not like I cannot read it offhand, but I need to look at it from the Bible as you are looking at it as well. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life." What is this telling you and I? That as God gave grace freely, grace which is in the person of Jesus, his son, as he gave it freely, without us meriting it, which brings us to how a great Bible scholar defined grace. I'll tell you how he defined it. A great Bible scholar, Chuck Missler. He is my favorite Bible scholar. He might not be yours, but he is mine. Okay. He defined grace as G stands for God. That's God's. Then R stands for riches. A stands for art. C stands for Christ. And E stands for expense. So that is to say, God's riches at Christ's expense. You connect the dots, what it means. This is to tell you that God gave everything he has to us. And also, grace, or Christ's willingness to pay the price for you and I. You see, there is, yes, God gave. You are yet again. Jesus was willing to carry on, to lay down his life. He was willing. He is an obedient son. He was willing. Yeah, his father wills it. Jesus too was willing. So that's the thing you have to understand here. And then I would like to tell you something. Grace is willing. Just as I say, as I explained, Jesus is willing, which is grace. Grace is willing. Grace paid. Grace freed. Grace finally saved and still saves. That should ring a huge bell in your mind. How is grace willing? Because Jesus said he lays his life down because he can And no man can make him. He can't because he chooses to. Where does it, and his father wills it. We should read John chapter 10 to get the real picture here. Why grace is willing, for you to know why. John chapter 10. We have to read John chapter 10, 17 and 18. John chapter 10, verse 17 and 18. Verse 17, yeah. Say, therefore, doeth my Father love me. He's telling you, this is Jesus speaking, that his Father loves him because I lay down my life, because he laid down his life that I might take it again. You see, he does not just have the power to lay it down, he also have the power to bring himself out of the grave again. So, no man taketh it from me. See, that's to tell you that Jesus is calling the shots here. It's not the Pharisees. And then, but I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father. So there are two people involved in this whole willingness: the Father, the Son. So Jesus was the one calling the shots. It is true that the Pharisees or the Sadducees, they thought they were doing God's bidding, that Jesus was a blasphemer. That's what they thought. But yes, actually, they were doing God's bidding because it was fitting into God's plans. They did not, they were doing it thinking that they are trying to eradicate a blasphemer. But rather, they were doing God's will by doing it. So, yeah. That is that about the willingness of grace. The Father wills it, the Son wills it. Jesus was not coerced, he was not forced. That is why it's called grace. It's free. He did it from his heart, no string attached. He wanted to. So, moving on. How did grace pay? Jesus being wounded for our transgressions in Isaiah 53, verse 1 to 5. And also, the shedding of his blood lays it out for you. Isaiah 53, from verse 1 to 5. Lays it out for you how grace paid. You know, as the Bible says, that there is no forgiveness without the remission of see, no, sorry, there is no what am I trying? I will come back to that. There is this, what I'm trying to tell you is that without the shedding of an innocent blood, we can never be reconciled with the Father. It's simple, it's not gonna happen. So that's what I'm trying to say, but I have to look for that verse. Without the shedding of the innocent blood. So in John 19:30, it tells us how Jesus' blood was the answer to our problems. He freed us. Yeah? Okay. So, yeah, so this is to tell us that Jesus paid in full. When you are sick, he paid. When you are being transgressed, he paid. When you're restless, he paid. Name any sickness, name any situation in this life, Jesus went to the cross for it. So, grace went to the cross for it and said, what did he say? It is finished. Paid in full. It says this, tetelestai. That's what it says. Tetelestai. So, whenever you feel There's a danger coming your way. You just said Tenestita. Just say that. It means paid in full. You don't owe the devil nothing. So you have to say that. You know, if you cannot say, just say it is finished. Or you say paid in full. That's what Jesus said when he was on that cross. So we don't owe the devil anything. He nailed everything to the cross. So, moving on. How did grace free us? Romans 4:16 tells you that. And then Romans 4:16 tells us how grace freed us, and as well as he freed us by dying on the cross. If Jesus did not die, we will still be under the law and bondage, all bondage. You know, our Christian faith is based on the fact that Jesus Christ died. He has to die, and it is not a tragedy, it is a victory. You know, John 19:30 tells us as well about that. I think we should read it. We should read John 19:30, what it tells us about Jesus dying, going to the cross for us. John 19:30. Yeah. Okay. Great. When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, "It is finished." And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. That is why I said to you, children of God, whenever you are in any situation, just say, paid in full, or you say, it is finished. That's what our Lord said on the cross. So, yeah, Jesus had to die so that we will make sense. If he didn't die, there won't be Christianity, because our Christian faith is based on the fact that Jesus Christ died and rose after. That's the gospel, by the way. The gospel is all about telling the world that there is a man called Jesus, called Grace, that wrote us a letter. His father wrote us a letter through what? Using the blood of his son to write us letter. That is what the gospel is. God literally used the blood of Jesus to write us a letter. So that is why you cannot hear about grace and ignore it. There was a price that was paid. There was a price that was paid for you and I. So, how did grace save? Because Jesus rose from the dead and conquered sin. If Jesus did not rise from the dead, there will be no hope for us. But because grace was willing, grace paid the price, grace freed us from the bondage of sin by shedding his blood. Grace saved us by dying on that cross and rising after 3 days. That is why true Christianity exists today. And that is what the Christian faith is based upon. That is what defines Christianity. You can find all this we have talked about in Romans 5, Romans 6, Romans 7, Romans 8. It hammers away all about grace, what grace did for you and I. So, to round this up, if you have heard about grace today in the person of Jesus and you ignore it is on you. It's on you, it's not on God. As people always lament on the issue that, how can a loving God send one to hell? Well, here is the thing. God has not sent anyone to hell yet. You have today to make a decision where you want to go, where you want to spend your eternity. Christmas season is not the season to drink and to eat. Overeating, overfeeding is even a sin. You know that. And then this is a season to sit back, since it's a holiday and Thanksgiving season and testimonies. This is a time to sit back with your family and begin to think, to remember all the goodness of God from January to December, and thank Him for it. If anywhere, if you have gotten it wrong, or there is still an error, this is the season to sit down with your family and iron it out with God. This is the season to go down on your knees and reconnect yourself to Jehovah. It is not a season for you to endanger yourselves by drinking non-stop and doing and engaging in other activities that does not glorify God. So if you've heard this message today and you would like to take that decision, pray this after me. Lord Jesus, I come before your throne of grace, and I ask that you forgive me my sins, because I am a sinner and I have recognized your lordship, and I am here today to receive you into my life. Come in, Jesus, and be the Lord and Savior of my life. And from today onwards, I will choose to serve you forever, and I will never return back to my old ways with your help, Jesus. Thank you for making me yours today. In Jesus' name, amen. So, folks, I want to leave you with this encouragement. This is the season to think, like I just said, to go back and think, to go back and reminisce, sit back, take that time, and listen to God. Because anytime, even in the Bible, anytime God wants to reach out to the children of Israel, first thing you hear Him say, listen. God always wants you to be quiet. This is the time you find a place, you and your family. If you have one, if you're alone, it's okay as well. Listen to what God has to say to you this season. And know that He has not forsaken you, that He wants the best for you and your family. So I wish you Merry Christmas in advance, and I'll see you next week, which is Christmas. Bye. I love you. Jesus loves you more. Grace is looking and watching over you. Take care of yourself.